Welcome back to another episode of Auto Meet TV, where we take you on another journey of more cars, more fun, and more content. Whoa, what are you doing?
Check this out. Whoa. Okay, press play, mate. Press play.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity, you know the roof on fire. We go boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance like the roof on fire. We go drink drinks and take shots until we fall out like the roof on fire. Now, baby, get my booty naked, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire. Tell him, baby, 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 I'm on fire. I tell her, baby, 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 I'm a fireball.
Nice to meet you. So I saw all your cars. They look brilliant. I think there's a story behind them. Can you tell me a little about them?
My name is Ishan Khan. I'm the director of X-UK LTD, also known as Zenon's UK, and also our newly formed company, which is Hyperworks, with another two partners. The story behind the company is, as I was growing up, I had a time where I spent, I'd say, a multiple number of years playing Gran Turismo. And my fascination with the game was whenever I got to a certain point, I'd win a special car, which would be an LM car. So the story actually starts with this vehicle here. There's a lot of history behind this car. So this was my guinea pig for me to learn how to 3D scan, CAD design, 3D print, post-process the part, which means sanding, filling, perfecting the edges. And then from that stage, we went to making and manufacturing molds, which the whole procedure from start to finish, I didn't have no education on. I wasn't educated in the field, and I'm self-taught on everything. So the process actually took 5.5 years. I went through 3 scanners, 4 3D printers. It was a very difficult journey, but I knew I'd get to it at some point. After this car was completed and the whole procedure from start to finish, which made my company manufacture everything in-house. Because when we had COVID, I was manufacturing a lot of products in China. And the problem I had was the containers shot up in price, raw materials shot up. I just struggled to provide customers with an end product. So once this car was complete on the 28th of March this year, 2023, I challenged myself, how fast can I create another car? The GTR that you see there, that took me 2.5 months. I did the QA, that took me 2 months. So the time started dropping. Then I got approached by some friends and they showed me this model that you see on the roof of the Lamborghini. We've been watching your videos, can you do this? And I said, hell yeah, bring it on. So what you see here is about three and a half, four weeks of work. Wheels, the air suspension was fitted by a third party company. And then I designed, 3D printed, and attached these parts. And the last part was printed yesterday. But if you have a look at this side, the skirt's missing. So I then decided to draw all over the car because a lot of people couldn't understand, you know, the finish.
I mean, the journey must have been so long for you.
If I could say anything to anyone in terms of motivation or life itself, 5.5 years, 3.5 weeks. So the sky's the limit. You put your mind to something, you can achieve anything you want.
It's amazing to hear your story, and obviously it's a motivation for everyone that's watching, and for everyone here seeing all this.
Dreams.
Yeah.
Don't ever give up. People said we can't do it. Everybody said it's impossible. Friends, family. That's what motivated me.
Honestly, I wish you the best of luck in your journey and for the future.
Thank you.
And much respect, mate. Thank you very much, Rain. Thank you. I saw your car, it looks amazing. Can you tell me a little about it?
Yeah, it's basically it was bought as a standard 32 GTR, 993, so obviously the latest spec. Bought from Harlow in Essex, plain white, pearl when I got it, built it to what it is today. Bought it in 2013, so like quite a while now.
So how long have you owned it for?
About 10 years.
If you had an unlimited amount of money to buy your dream car, what would it be?
That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Still a lot more to do yet. Got some stuff just landing now from Japan, so it's got more engine work to do this year. The beginning of next year, the interior work still to do, but yeah, it's ongoing.
Brilliant. Well, it's nice to meet you, and thank you very much.
Hey, True, bend that up for the track. You know, take it to the top, and that's the truth. Truth hurts.
Oh, yeah. I'm looking at the car. Can you tell me a bit about it?
So this is my 2001 model R34 Nissan Skyline. It's actually a GTT. It's got the full GTR conversion kit on it with the Z-tune front fenders and bonnet.
How long have you owned this car for?
I owned it now just a bit over a year.
And I'm looking, it says 7 days performance. Did you actually get it from the company?
Yeah. So I was actually the lucky bastard that won this car off 7 days performance competition.
That's awesome. If you had the opportunity to own any car,
yeah,
which car would it be?
Honestly, it would be this car. Well, if anything, probably the GTR. But yeah, the 34 Nissan Skyline has been my dream car since I was a kid. You know, the Fast and Furious days, Need for Speed Underground, all that sort of stuff.
That's pretty cool. It was nice to talk to you, and yeah, man, I hope you enjoy it.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
I want to start off by saying, what an absolute beast. Tell me a bit about the car.
So, it's an active red R34 GTR, one of the only few here in the UK. This one's a bit more unique. It's RB31.5 stroker, big single turbo conversion, running really high power, but me personally, I don't run it max power, I run it low as I can, but that's still a bit naughty. So yeah, it's a special bit of kit.
How long have you owned this car for?
I've only had this for 6 months, roundly about 6 months, but yeah.
My last question would be, if you had the opportunity to own any car in the world, what would it be?
Obviously this is everybody's dream, you know, but if we're talking silly cars, the XJ220s that we got here are crazy. That's like, again, Gran Turismo kind of vibes, but XJ220 or like a Pagani Zonda or something like that, the older ones, that's like out of this world goals, but this is more than enough for me, you know.
That's lovely to hear. Well, it was nice talking to you, and it was, you know, nice checking out the car, and have a good time, man.
Cheers, mate.
All right, take care. What a fantastic build. Tell me a bit about the car.
Yeah, so it's a genuine E30 M3. Got a lot of modifications on it. The engine's been swapped. This has got the E46 M3 engine in it, the S54, and it's supercharged. It's making around 600 brake horsepower. It's got full custom paint, it's four-stage pearl, airlift suspension, 18-inch BBS RS wheels, custom interior. Yeah, it's just a, you know, nice modified car.
That's great. How long have you owned this car for?
Quite a few years, but yeah, I'm selling it now, like, because yeah, I'm just building another project, so yeah.
If you had the opportunity to own any car in the world or build a car from scratch, what would it be?
Oh, tough question. I'd probably build another E30 M3, to be honest. Yeah, another one of these, but do it slightly different, yeah.
That's fantastic to hear. Well, it was nice talking to you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
We had an amazing time at the Gravity Show. We saw some unique builds, cars, drifting, everything, the lot. An event highly recommended to be added on next year's list. Like, share and subscribe to the channel, comment below and give us your feedback and opinions on the video. See you next week. Adios.